Now that we have the vector embeddings for each of our movie plots stored in Postgres database, it is time to combine it all with contextual search. And this is where we will see PGVector in action. We'll do it in two steps. First, we'll take the search phrase and encode it to get a vector embedding. And then we'll write PostgreSQL query and use PGVector to retrieve the closest vectors to that search phrase. Here, we won't use any user interface yet. We'll just make a proof of concept that all of that, together with a bare Node.js, TensorFlow, and PGVector, works fine. And we will add Next.js interface in the next session. But for now, we'll keep it again quite simple. Let's start by creating a file. A new file which is called recommender, because this is where we are going to add our recommendation logic. And we will use the dependencies, very similar to our encoder file. So we can copy some of that for us. And here you can see again that we are going to use TensorFlow. We are going to use encoder from TensorFlow to convert the search phrase, whatever search phrase we will select, into a set of vectors. Then we also will connect to Postgres. And for this, we will need all the credentials, which we store in .env, as well as we will need access to the certificate. For this, we use FS dependency. Nice. We also can add our PG dependency, which we already installed. Here we are not going to use a PG promise because we just need to get a single request. We are not going to store multiple rows with the data here, just sending the request to retrieve the response using PGVector. But we still need to connect to the Postgres database for this. Let's copy the configuration which we already created in the previous section. By the way, you haven't seen the previous section. The link should be up here or in the description to all the episodes. And also check the accompanying material, which will have all the code snippets which we are using as well. You can find it in the description box of this video if you are watching it on YouTube. So we have the configuration and we can use that configuration to establish connection with Postgres. But we can do it a bit later because now let's actually work a bit with the model. So let's load our TensorFlow model. And once it is loaded, we can use it to create embeddings for the search query, for some kind of a search query, which we will select right now. So wait, model embed. And since we are not having any interface yet, let's just use something we would like to watch about. And who doesn't like a lot of cute puppies? So that will be our search phrase for now. Let me change actually embeddings to embedding request, and embedding will be the response or the array with all the values from TensorFlow. And I need the first one, just the one for our string. So that's why I put zero there. So now we are ready to connect to Postgres. And let's initialize the client using our configuration and then connect to the database using that client. And once we are connected, we can send a request to query the data from the database. And this is where we are going to use PGVector. So client query, and within the query, let's select all the movie plots that we have. We will order the movie plots depending how close the embedding is to the embedding of the search phrase, which we have, to the cute puppies. And you can see that we are using here this strange symbol. That actually means that we are looking for the nearest neighbors by L2 distance. More you can find in the documentation of the of PGVector. We will limit the results to 5. Let's get the 5 closest results. We don't really need many to output. And that's the complete query. So, of course, we need to catch any errors which might occur. And we also need not to forget to close the connection once we are done. And we also need not to forget, of course, to output the response from the server, whatever we will get there from Postgres. So we can just output the rows which we get from our Postgres response. And let's see if that will work, because this is actually pretty short, but should function completely. So let's run the recommender.js and see what kind of movies about a lot of puppies we can retrieve. Okay, that's not very user-friendly. Yes, it's all our embeddings. Let me scroll to the top. The first result we got is actually the secret life of pets. And since we were looking for a lot of cute puppies, that kind of seems to be reasonable. What else did we get? Oh, that's very difficult to navigate. The next result we got, Clifford's really big movie, which talks about a giant Labrador retriever. And I guess there might be even some puppies there. And the rest also looks like skilled veterinarians. So it does seem that whatever TensorFlow recommended us as closest to a lot of cute puppies is indeed reasonable suggestion. That works, but it definitely lacks some convenient user-friendly interface. So in the next step, we are going to use Next.js to set up our front-end and our back-end and connect them together and get those nice recommendations about puppy movies. See you in the next video.